Welcome to Esvignon High School and Junior College. We had already started with the computers of Standard 8, Chapter Number 5, and had completed the first part of this chapter, Introduction to Adobe Photoshop. Today, we are going to continue with the part 2 of this chapter. We had already learned about how to open Adobe Photoshop and how to create a new file, how to open an existing file, how to save a file, and many more things. So, in this video, we are going to continue further. In Photoshop, we use foreground color to paint, fill, and stroke selections. The background color is used to make gradient fills and fill in the erased areas of an image. The default foreground color is white. You can change the foreground or the color picker. Now we will learn how to change the foreground or the background color. First, click on the foreground or the background color selection box in the toolbox. Second, the color picker dialog box appears on the screen. Drag the color slider, click on the color selection box and choose a color. Then click on OK. In this image here, you can see color picker dialog box. On the left hand side, you can see color selection box, and on the right hand side, color slider. Let's see the selection tools are used to select all or any part of a picture to perform cut, copy, edit, or retouching operations. The selection tools are categorized under two major groups. First one is Marquee tool and the second one is Lasso tools. Let's learn about the Marquee tool. With the help of the Marquee tools, you can select areas of an image in rectangular, square, elliptical, or circular shapes. Here you can see the Marquee tools box on the screen. Let's know about the steps to be followed while using this tool. First, open the image. Second, click the Marquee tool from the toolbox. The cursor appears on a crosshair. Third, click and hold left mouse button and then drag over a Marquee. Fourth, you will notice that a dash border has covered the object you have selected. Here, in this image, you can see elliptical selection. Here, in this next image, you can see single row selection. Let's learn about the lasso tools. The lasso, polygonal lasso, magnetic lasso tools are hidden in the toolbox under one and the same icon. The icon on the toolbox displays the last tool selected. To open the floating menu, right click on the arrow in the lower right corner of the displayed icon. You can see the lasso tools. Steps to be followed while using the lasso tools. First, open the image. Then select the lasso tool. Click once in the image at any part. Fourth, drag the mouse around the part of the drag the image which is to be selected. Fifth, release the mouse at the end point. You will notice the selection. In this image, we can see use of the lasso tool. Let's know about polygon lasso tool. Select the polygon lasso tool. Click once in the image at any point of the part to be selected. Move the mouse and you will notice that a line will follow your polygon lasso. Fourth, clicking again will draw the first line between the two mouse clicks. Let's see the fifth point. Keep on moving the mouse pointer over the area to be selected and you will find another line indicating the selection. Sixth point, click again to increase the selection. Continue this process till you reach the starting point. Close the marquee by clicking at the starting point. In this image here, you can see use of polygonal lasso tool. Let's see how to use magnetic tool. First, select the magnetic lasso tool. Click on any part of the image to be selected and drag the mouse pointer around the object to select it. Double click at the ending point. Observe the selection. In this image here, we can see use of magnetic lasso tool. We will learn about magic wand tool. It is located near the top of the Photoshop toolbox. It allows you to select an area of an image based on its color. When you click an area in an image with the magic wand, all areas which are a similar color are selected. You can specify various options to determine the exact selection. The steps to be followed while using magic wand tool are: select the magic wand tool in the toolbox. Second, in the options bar, select a tolerance value 0 to 255. This determines how closely to match color. Higher tolerance means a large selection. Check anti-aliased to define a smooth edge to the selection. Check contiguous to select only areas which are joined together. Check sample all layers to select areas from all layers. Third, click the image in an area which you want to select. Here in this image, you can see the use of magic wand tool. Let's know about the crop tool. With the help of a crop tool, you can select an area of an image and discard everything outside this area. Cropping reduces the dimensions of an image. It is not the same as resizing. Resizing reduces or enlarges the entire image and everything in it. Cropping does not alter the size of an image content at all. Let's follow the steps and crop an image. First, open the image. Second, select the crop tool in the toolbox. Third, select an area of the image to retain just the same as making a normal selection. Fourth point, when you release the mouse button, the area to be retained is highlighted. This is what the new image will look like. Fifth, you can move or transform the crop area by dragging the selection or the selection handles. 6. Hit your enter key to perform the crop. In the image on the right hand side, you can see the cropped image. Move tool. Move tool allows you to move a selection or entire layer by dragging it with your mouse or using your keyboard arrow keys from one location to another. The steps are 1. Open an image. 2. Click the move tool from the toolbox. 3rd point, while holding the left mouse button, drag it to the point where you want to place the selection and release the mouse button. In the slide here, you can see selecting an image. In this image, you can see the space empty from where the image is being moved. I hope you all have understood till here. In this video, we have learned about how to change the background and foreground color and various selection tools like Marquee tools and Lasso tools. We will meet soon in the next video and continue with the remaining part. Do practice this. Stay safe. Thank you. We will meet soon in the next video.